Okay. Welcome back. Today we're going to do the passenger side fender, flat fender. We've got two. Let's see if I can show you here. We've got to remove the battery tray. Take the bolts out of there. We've got to remove all our support braces. And of course, remove all the bolts from the inner fender. Got to take this trim off again. That's going to be fun. And we got to take the bolts off right in here. Okay. Let's get to it. Got me. The Jeep just gave me a dirt turn. Okay, let's see if we can get it. So, the screws I just cut off are still screwed into the body of the fender and to this at the same time. So what I need to do is just take off this whole trim. When I take the fender off, the trim will come with it. If I can get to all the screws, that's going to be the side factor here. Remember the last one? The other side. Everything's going to break it over.
Okay, cut the head off. Now, just pull it this way. Ta-da! Alright. So that's disconnected. The back part's disconnected. So we just need to get the fender off.
Oh, we're getting closer. So much closer. Okay.
bolt. Disconnected. Let's find out. Shock tower. Nope, don't connect to the winch. Okay, Fender's on, I'm done. Alright, so now we need to clean all of this. We're gonna clean this, clean that. We need to cut our old Fender. We gotta clean that up, clean this fender up, paint it, and yeah, get to work. First thing we need to do is cut up this fender. We can attach it to this one. Which is from here. this compacting back in somewhat. Need to chop off from here. I'm trying to get both holes stay on here because last time on the other side I cut off this one hole, so now I don't really know the orientation of the hood. I'll have to guess the hood latch, so I want to cut around this so I can clear this right here. See how that's going to work. And I got bud by. Okay. We need to cut this off right here. Something's holding me up. I don't know what it is. Not hold me up, hold me back. This is broken. I feel like this should be closer this way. It won't go closer that way because it's wide. This needs to be pushed out. not anywhere up front, up here, that's all clear. And the only thing it looks like is, it looks like my fender needs to be on this side of the lip. Let's see what we did on the other side. What is preventing it from coming closer? Side, I cut a little more out right there. And that should have affected that much. Put the fender liner on this side of the flat fender. I'm probably going to unbolt this and move it back after I get this set. But other than that, it'll go back. I have more than a half of an inch gap between. You can't see, let me show you. Well, I've got quite a bit of gap right there. I mean, I guess it would flex. And I like this better because we got up under the tubes, and now I have both my holes for the hood so I can line it up easier, the hood latch. Yeah, it's not too bad, it's getting there.